It's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. It's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. It's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Inside me, super big. What's your hidden talent? We're back to that again.
The Church Kids Show.
Hey, friends, and welcome back to The Church Kids Show.
This is the final week of September, which means, did you remember your pajamas?
Happy Silly Sunday.
Yeah.
Hope you're all wearing your PJs to church today, if you remember.
Yeah, or, you know, if you got a, you know, pajama jacket, like this one, as I like to call it, my warm.
Yes, and pajama jacket.
And it is a pajama, because it's soft.
It's a flannel, but that's
sleep,
fine.
And you can sleep in it, because it's really soft. But if you didn't bring anything, that's okay. Just put them on tonight and wear them to bed.
You mean like they do every night?
I mean, I guess, yeah.
Anyway, this is our last week talking about God's purpose for us. Our faith declaration is God has a purpose for me.
We each have special talents and traits that God has given us that he can use for his glory and his plan for you and for the world around you.
For example, if you love to speak to people or write, you can use your words to bring people to Christ. Mm-hmm. If you love kids, you could be a teacher, serve in the church nursery one day, or help out with your younger siblings. Whoever the Lord has created you to be can be used for great things.
Speaking of special talents, we are going to be trying out some TikTok challenges to see if we are as talented as some other people in the world.
Let's do it! Here we go, our first challenge. Ah, yes. So this girl on, this gal on TikTok really is impressed with her ability to fold her tongue in different ways. And the first one she does is just the simple taco, as
the
it's called.
The simple taco.
Which is just when you go like this. Can you do it? Taco. Uh-huh. Easy. Church kids, can you do it? Okay, the next one she did was this.
Simple taco.
See? Did you see?
Oh,
see?
She's biting it. I don't have to bite it. Right, right, right for this?
Yes, you do. Oh, wait, I
do not have to bite it. Something I can do.
Am I doing it? Except she like really goes, she goes.
Like she bites on it. That's like cheating, I feel like.
This one's harder.
So I feel
me.
Like we can do better than she can.
Okay. The next one is fold in half.
I think I can do it. Yeah, you can do that pretty well.
You have to, you can't use your lip. I don't think that's right.
I don't know if I can do that one. It's not flexible.
Okay.
My tongue is flexible enough.
The final one is.
I bet you know I know what it is.
The challenging clover.
The clover! I can do the clover.
I can't do the clover.
Here, let me.
I've never been able to do it.
Let me swallow my saliva so I don't gleek on you or the church kids. Or one of the people in the other room because it shoots really far.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Wow, I cannot do that.
I don't know how to explain how I do it, but I just do, and that's all you need to know.
He's playing the mouth trumpet. Can you play the mouth trumpet?
I don't know, he's going like fur, 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 fur. He's going like fur. I can do it a different way. What's his song?
That's pretty good. That sounds nice. Like a meeting at a restaurant, listening to someone play the trumpet thing. Job.
What is she doing?
She's lifting her eyebrows.
Eyebrow stuff. Okay, eyebrows.
Okay, so first she does both.
Okay.
Which is
I think everyone can do that unless you're an infant.
And then she does one at a time, which I can't do.
Well, you have also something pulling on your forehead, so that makes it harder, right?
Just take them. No, I really can't do it even without that.
Okay, I'm pretty sure I can definitely do my left one. See, and left, left, and then right, right. I forget to breathe though. Okay. The wave?
And then
okay.
She does the wave.
I need someone to tell me if I'm doing the wave, because I don't actually know if I can do it. Let me make sure I breathe though. Okay, here I go. Wait.
Oh, maybe. Kind
Crystal,
of.
Am I doing the wave?
Does that look like the wave to you?
What else we got?
Okay, we have the finger fan thing.
Oh no, I'm not flexible. I'm not flexible. Stop it. You quit that.
You can do this. You just push your fingers into place and make a little face.
I'm telling you. I got Vienna sausage looking fingers, and
so
I don't
do
think.
So do I. Nothing I can do this.
Oh my gosh!
Though.
I gotta be really careful, or I'll start to like freak out.
Why will you freak out?
Am I doing it?
I don't think so.
Am I doing it? I'm not that flexible, okay?
Oh gosh. That would be a great dinosaur hand puppet.
Ah! Every time I put my ring finger over it, starts.
This side is hard. Bing, 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 bing.
Maybe I'll try my left hand's less swollen. Oh gosh, I like have no flexibility over here. I don't think I can.
Do
yeah, I can.
Wow.
Yeah. Can't do that one. Can't do it.
Okay, the other one is you have to try and lick your elbow.
I already know I can't do that. I don't need to even.
Church
try.
Kids, can you lick your elbow?
The answer is no. Unless you're very, very flexible and you got a short.
I feel like
forearm.
That's not that. It's like your this back here has to be able to be like dislodged.
Yeah, it'd have to get closer. And you know what? I'm already not flexible, so I'm a good. I'm a good like 6 inches away. Not happening.
Left.
Actually, I got kind of close. This is worth my body going through pain. No, it's not.
Oh my gosh. Okay, well, that was honestly really strange.
Is there any more?
There was one that was like singing with your mouth closed. Can you sing with your mouth closed? Oh. You are alive, and there's nothing to take your place.
Your place.
And I changed it. I feel like your mouth is supposed to be closed. That was really weird. So
quite strange.
Who knew? So many people had so many random and unnecessary talents.
Church Kids, if you have a cool talent, take a video and tag us at Champion Center Church Kids so we can see it too.
Do it! Now let's see if you are talented enough to win this week's game.
Let's go.
Yo, this is Teacher AJ here with another game, another week. This week, we got a game called Guess That Food. Everybody say it with me, Guess That Food. I got 5 foods set up right in front of me. I don't know what they are. I got my partner gonna feed them to me because I just can't do it. I don't know if I'm not gonna like it. I don't know if I'm gonna like it. I don't know if I'm gonna know what it is. I don't know. Okay, Church Kids, so I got 5 mystery foods. For each food I get right, it's 1 point. So whoever you're going against, the most points wins the game. Let's go.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Sometimes I can't deny
But then my God reminds me, in him I can do all things. He chose me, like 1 Peter 2 and 9.
Chosen generation, royal priesthood, holy nation, God's special possession that we may proclaim the praises of him. He brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light. Now he has brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light. We're a chosen generation, royal priesthood, holy nation, God's special possession that we may proclaim the praises of him. He brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light. Now he has brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light.
Now say I'm chosen.
Yeah, I'm chosen.
There's no doubt in who I be. Now people ask me about G-O-D, I tell them he and me. Now there's no enemy that's seeing me as long as he with me. The only enemy is enemy, and even then he Campbell suits, good. Now we are all God's people, no matter if you're rich or from the hood. It's all good. Just know that God's love is real love. We mess up, yup, still love, we're chosen. Ain't nothing up.
1 Peter 2:9. God tells the lost, hey, you, yeah, you're mine. Chosen by me, all that you need is the faith of a mustard seed. Hey, special possession.
Yep.
Loving us is God's profession. Precious, chosen every day like Smeagol in the ring, but not as creepy.
Praise his name, praise his name.
Lift his name and seek the truth.
Bring him faith, bring him faith.
Testify how he changed you.
We proclaim
the praises of the one who saves.
In his name, in his name.
Jesus is the name
we praise.
Caught up in a world that'll tell me lies. Had me feeling lost, sometimes I can't deny. But then my God reminds me, in him I can do all things. He chose me, like 1 Peter 2 and 9. Chosen generation, royal priesthood, holy nation, God's special possession that we may proclaim the praises of him. He brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light. Now he has brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light. We're a chosen generation, royal priesthood, holy nation, God's special possession that we may proclaim the praises of him. He brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light. Now he has brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light.
It can take some time to learn what God's purpose is for our lives.
Church kids, your challenge this week is to think about the gifts God has given you and who he has created you to be and how he can use you for great things.
And although being able to sing with your mouth closed or lick your elbow are super cool talents,
the coolest,
I bet yours are even better.
Honestly, anything is probably better than those talents at this point.
Yeah, pretty much like this.
Okay, well, let's get into today's lesson.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Set go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do. Set go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Oh, hi friends. I just finished making these flowers. Do you like them?
Wee! Hiya, Emily. Hiya, friends.
Hi, Shine. Look what I made.
A flower? How wonderful.
Well, Shine, it doesn't smell like a real flower.
Still, that's a beautiful flower you made. It makes me think of a very important question. Who made you?
Let's go on a Bible adventure to find out. Friends, shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me. Woohoo! Now, friends, pretend to put on your adventure bags. I've got mine right here.
I know some picture passes that will help us.
Friends, you and I will be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. It's a group of men, women, boys, and girls.
Friends, which picture pass do you think it is? Friends, you're great guessers. If you guessed the people, then you're right. Catch the people in your adventure bags. Shine, what's next?
This one's a bright light high in the sky during the daytime.
Friends, which one do you think it is? Great job, friends! It is the sun! Catch it in your adventure bags!
Now for the last one. It's so cute and cuddly, too. It wags its tail when it's happy.
Friends, which one do you think Shine is talking about? Friends, you've got it! It is the puppy! Catch that puppy in your adventure bags! Friends, count with me. 1, 2, 3! Yep, they're all here. Now let's zip our adventure bags together. Now it's time to fly! Whoa! Shine, I want to make sure we find the right answer to our question.
The Bible can help us.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
In the beginning, that story's from the book of Genesis in the Bible.
It's about how God made the whole world. Let's see how he did all that.
We live in a beautiful world. Just look at the amazing things around you. Let's go back to the beginning and see what the Bible tells us about how it all began. In the beginning, God made the heavens and the earth. God moved over the darkness and said, "Light!" He called the light day, and he called the darkness night. Day one, done! Then, God made a space to separate the waters above from the waters below. He called the space sky. Day two, done. God gathered the waters together and dry ground appeared. He called the ground land and the waters seas. Then he made plants like grass, grain, and trees. Day three, done. Then God made lights in the sky. He made the sun for the day, the moon for the night, and all the stars. Day four, done. God made fish to swim in the waters and birds to fly in the sky. "Have babies," he told them. "Fill the world with splashing and singing." Day five, done. Next, God made animals. He made farm animals, wild animals, and animals that crawl on the ground. "Just one more thing to make," God said. "The most special thing of all." So, in his image, God made man and woman. "Have babies," he said. "Take charge of the world. Care for the fish, the birds, and the animals." Day six, done. Then God looked at everything he had made. "It's very good," he said. So on the seventh day, he rested and made that day special. Day seven, done.
God was busy.
He was. After all, he did make everything. Shine, I'm ready to answer the question.
Okay, who made you?
God made me amazing.
Wee, that's the answer.
I'm gonna go ask Guy the Bible Guy about that. See ya, Shine.
See ya, Emily.
Come on.
Amazing. Hi, Emily.
Hi, Guy. I have a question for you. Who made you?
God made me amazing. God made everyone everywhere.
I have a picture pass about that. Friends, what do you call a group of men, women, boys, and girls? Great guesses, friends. It's the people.
God made all people, and nobody, I mean nobody, is the same.
I watched a Bible story about how God made the whole world and everything and everyone in it.
God made people for something very special. That's because we can be God's friend when we follow Jesus.
Do you know a Bible verse about that?
Sure do. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn a verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay, listen to what the Bible says. Psalm 139:14. How you, that's God, made me, that's me, is amazing and wonderful. Woohoo!
Friends, repeat it with me.
Psalm 139:14.
Psalm 139:14.
How you, that's God.
How you, that's God.
Made me, that's me.
Made me, that's me.
Is amazing and wonderful. Woohoo!
Is amazing and wonderful. Woohoo!
Great job, friends. Now say the whole verse with us. Psalm 139:14. How you, that's God,
made me,
that's me, is amazing and wonderful. Woohoo! Great job, friends.
Thanks so much. Bye, Guy.
Bye, Emily. Bye, friends.
Come on. Hi, friends. The people picture pass reminds us that God made us to be his friend. Isn't that amazing? Friends, say today's Bible verse with me. Psalm 139:14. How you, that's God, made me, that's me, is amazing and wonderful. Woohoo! Rizzlin' Razzles, do you hear that song? It's coming from Mr. Music's singing studio. Come on, let's go.
Oh, hi, Emily.
Hi, Mr. Music. You always make new songs, which makes me think of today's question. Who made you?
God made me amazing.
That's right, Mr. Music. We learned about that in today's Bible story.
God made the whole world, and he made the moon and the stars.
Oh, wait a second. I think I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass is a bright light high in the sky? That's right, friends. It's the sun.
God made the sun, too, and everything the sun shines on.
Everything that God made is so good. I'm glad he made us to be his friend.
That's pretty special. God made all of us amazing and wonderful.
Do you know a song about that?
Yes. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing a song with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Okay, we're gonna sing the whole song together, okay? And all you have to do is repeat after me. Ready?
Yeah.
Here we go. He made the sun.
He made the sun.
He made the moon.
He made the moon.
He made the stars.
He made the stars.
He made the sky.
He made the sky.
He made the birds.
He made the birds.
He made the fish.
He made the fish.
And best of all,
and best of all,
God made
me.
God made me amazing.
God made me amazing.
And
wonderful.
And wonderful.
And I am special.
And I am special.
Because I'm made by God. God made me amazing.
God made me amazing.
And wonderful.
And wonderful.
And I am special.
And I am special.
Because I'm made by God. He made the sun.
He made the sun.
He made the moon.
He made the moon.
He made the stars.
He made the stars.
He made the sky.
He made the sky.
He made the birds.
He made the birds.
He made the fish.
He made the fish.
And best of all.
And best of all.
God made me. God made me amazing.
God made me amazing.
And wonderful.
And wonderful.
And I am special.
And I am special.
Because I'm made by
God.
God made me amazing.
God made me amazing.
And wonderful.
And wonderful.
And I am special.
And I am special.
Because I'm made by God. Because I'm made by God. Because I'm made by God.
Yeah. Now, stand up on your feet to worship God with music, singing, and dancing.
You made my ears.
One, two.
So I can listen. You made my eyes.
One, two.
So I can see. You made my arms.
One, two.
So I can praise you. You made my heart. So I can love. Every word I speak. Every thought I think. Everything I do. My whole self belongs.
Shine! Hiya, Shine! Wait till you hear about our great Bible adventure!
Do you remember the answer to the question, who made you?
Sure I do! Friends, say it with me! God made me amazing!
Whee! And did God teach you a Bible verse?
Yup, yup, yuppers! Friends, let's say it for Shine! Psalm 139:14. How you, that's God, made me, that's me, is amazing and wonderful. Woohoo!
What about the picture passes?
The people picture pass reminds us that God made us to be his friend.
Yeah, that's very, very special.
And the sun picture pass reminds us that God made the sun.
And everything the sun shines on.
But Shine, I didn't talk to anybody about the puppy picture pass.
Think about the puppy and all the animals God made.
God did make some really amazing animals.
God made us even more amazing and wonderful than the animals.
You mean God loves me even more than he loves a cute little puppy?
He sure does. Now let's pray that our friends will know how amazing they are to God.
Okay, friends, bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together. Dear God, help us to know how amazing and wonderful we are to you. Thank you for making us to be your friend. In Jesus' name, amen. Camels and coconuts! It's time to go! We'll see you next time!
For another Bible adventure!
Bye-bye, friends!
We are so excited to announce that next weekend is the first weekend of Mind Monsters!
Woo! So brush up on your faith acronym and get ready to defeat some monsters! Wah!
And if you have no idea what we're talking about, tune in next week to find out.
But before we start battling those pesky mind monsters, let's say our memory verse for this month one last time together. Ready?
1 Peter 2:9, but you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession.
God has a purpose for you.
We will see you for Mind Monsters next weekend. But until then, don't forget, it's a great day
to be a church kid! Bye!